side property and angle property. We are going to apply these models. they are two similar parameters. Okay, similar parameters. This theorem we have, and we have Pythagoras theorem. How to prove Pythagoras using this similarity? I think from your lower classes you learned what is Pythagoras theorem. But here we are going to prove this Pythagoras using similarity. And also, converse of Pythagoras. Converse of Pythagoras. These are all the content it will be in the similar triangles. How to prove two figures, whether it is similar or not, using ASA, SSS, and AA property, and RHS also. And we have put some four theorems, ABT theorems, area of two similar triangles, Pythagoras, and converse of theorem. So, today I am going to teach only the. So, these all are out of syllabus this year. Area of two similar triangles, Pythagoras theorem, converse of Pythagoras, these all are out of syllabus. So, we have only one theorem this year, BBT theorem. This another name is called Thales theorem. It is called BBT or Thales. Okay, let me explain the statement first. Let me draw the figure in the figure. So, ABC is a triangle. What this BPT says, BPT or another name is Thales theorem. What he says is, in a given triangle ABC, a line is drawn one parallel to one side of the triangle. A line is drawn parallel to one side of the triangle. It divides other two sides in equal ratio. It divides other two sides in distinct points and divides in equal ratio. That means, so this is the statement. What he is saying, the triangle ABC, D is the line parallel to BC. If D is parallel to BC, this D divided is ABC into two equal ratio. That is AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. This is the proof. What's the proof? DE parallel to BC. This is given. So, this DE divided other two sides in equal ratio. That means AD by DB is equal to AE by BC. This is the term we are going to prove it. So, I think everybody understood the statement. Once again, I am repeating, a line is drawn parallel to one side of a triangle. It divides other two sides in equal ratio. That is AE parallel to BC and AB divided by DB is equal to AE by BC. Or we can do another also. What? AB by AB also you can write. AB by AB is equal to AE by BC. This is AE by AC. This is the corollary of the theorem. So this is also given the same, both are same. Okay. So how am I going to prove this? So in the theorem, it's what you will write. Given to prove, given to prove, proof, and any construction. So what is given here? ABC is a triangle and AE is the line which is parallel to BC. This is given. Okay. So we have to prove AB by AE is equal to AE by AC. So here I am going to do some construction. I am going to join BC and DE, and I am going to draw the perpendicular line DN, and from E to is all the construction. Now we will take this triangle ABE and E. These two triangles are going to take. Okay, this line is perpendicular. So what I have drawn, DN perpendicular to the AC is the construction, and EM perpendicular to AB. Now I will take the triangle. Triangle ABE divided by triangle BDE, triangle area of triangle ABE, area of triangle, area I am writing, area of triangle ABE. What is the area of triangle ABE? Means base is the height. If I take, look at the diagram, if I take AD is the base and EM is the height. Because EM I draw perpendicular to AD. So EM is the height. AB is the base and EM is the height. So half integral base is AB, height is EM. And the So area of BCE is